Employability skills can be defined as those soft skills which employers look for in a potential employee. Employability skills are best developed when these skills are integrated across the curriculum. The vocational curriculum developed by PSSCIVE aims to provide students with employability and vocational skills to support school to work transition, occupational mobility and lifelong learning. Employability skills covers communication skills, self-management, ICT skills, entrepreneurship development and green skills. Let us see industry experts and employers' view on importance of employability skills.
Apart from the domain knowledge, whatever is required for the students, the basic employability skills are also incorporated within the qualification packs which are developed by the sector skill councils. By the term employability skills, what we want to understand is, as per the industry representatives, what sector skill councils have understood, that what is the industry is asking for, while the students, after undergoing these training programs and the skill development programs, students are expected to have the basic knowledge of IT skills, some sort of communication skills, like what we talk about business language and all.
Basically, when we create this qualification pack or national occupation standards, it is developed based on the inputs collected from the industry people. Even when we discuss with the industry people, they give more emphasis on the employability skills. Employability skills, that too for a student at 9th standard, 10th standard, 11th standard, 12th standard, creates a platform for him to get more opportunity in when it comes to the employment. Apart from that, this also helps him to build his self-confidence. When it comes to communication, communication skill plays a very vital role for anybody to express his views and ideas. Even though the person is trained in skills and knowledge, when it gets expressed to the interviewer or in the employment, then it makes more sense.
आप कितने भी अच्छे इंजीनियर हो या कितने भी अच्छे टेक्निशियन हो, आपको अपनी बात कन्वे करते आना चाहिए और वो कन्वे करते जब ही आएगी जब उसकी कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स अच्छी होंगी. तो एक टेक्नीशियन को भी एट द लोअर मोस्ट लेवल एक कस्टमर से जब वो बात करता है तो वो कस्टमर क्या बता रहा है, क्या वो एक्सप्लेन कर रहा है, उसको ठीक से इंटरप्रेट करके उसको लिखते आना चाहिए. एक जो सुपरवाइज़र है जिसको शायद 8 से 10 गाड़ी एट अ पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम उसको हैंडल करनी होती हैं, उनको लुक आफ्टर करना होता है, और उसने वो सब 6 गाड़ियों का या 7 गाड़ियों का अलग अलग कस्टमर्स को अलग अलग टाइम दिया हुआ होता है, तो ही हैज़ टू मैनेज his own time and he has to manage the workflow in such a manner that those vehicles are delivered in time. हमारे पास computers का आजकल इतना ज़्यादा enrolled हो गया है हमारे daily life में, and even in technical life, जो हमको शायद लगता होगा कि technician को क्या ज़रूरत है, नहीं, उसको भी आज की तारीख में जो computers है उसको net पे जा कर के latest जो problems है computers cars में क्या problem है उसको website से download करना पड़ता है, उसको समझना पड़ता है. He should be able to navigate through those websites of various companies and see how to solve that problem. तो ये communication skills through computers is very important. I would like to talk of entrepreneurial skills. सबको job नहीं दी जा सकती, इसके लिए बहुत ज़रूरी है कि एंटरप्रेन्योर स्किल्स भी दें हम लोग, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा लोगों को एंटरप्रेन्योर बनना चाहिए, जिससे कि वो खुद तो जॉब लाइन से हट ही जाएंगे, अपने से 4-5 और भी जो उसके साथी लोग, उनके फ्रेंड्स हैं या उसके जूनियर बैच के लोग हैं, उनको भी एम्प्लॉयमेंट प्रोवाइड करेंगे.
अंडर दिस PSSCIVE सेक्टर यू हैव टू हैव अ कम्युनिकेशन स्किल, यू हैव टू हैव योर मार्केटिंग स्किल, योर सेल्स. इफ यू हैव ऑल दिस थिंग्स with you, you can do really wonders, and job is not a scarcity there. There is the insurance sector which is a wide open, number of vacancies are there, but we don't have a capable people to come there, capable candidate to come there, because communication is a big hurdle there. So this, with this communication, your employability will increase, and this communication will definitely will give you a better marketing and sales skill, which is the backbone of this industry.
Retail is a sector which is the second largest employment generating sector in India. Retail is not only about employment, it is also about self-employment. So in this endeavor, develop your skills to make yourself employable in all the subsectors of retail, whether it's the modern retail, whether it's a brick and mortar store, whether it is e-commerce, whether it's direct selling, whether it is FMCG or FMCD distribution. To have that self-employment skills, you have your employment, which is the key skills, which are nothing but your communication skills, your information technology skills, which is your digital literacy skills, which are very important. Retail is a sector which is all about service, customer service, selling, and very important point is about the orientation towards helping a customer to make a right decision.
Communication skills plays a very major role in interaction with the customers, tourists, or maybe your colleagues. So that is why it plays a very important role in order to sell your services and facilities, what you are offering in tourism and hospitality. Entrepreneurship, like it is, yes, entrepreneurship skills also plays a very important role. Like if you don't want to work with any tourism or hospitality sector, like you wanted to opt for your own business, you can have your own small business, you can have your own travel agency, you can be a tour operator, travel guide.
To work in the healthcare sector, very important and a very vital component is the soft skills and communication, as well as the employability skills. People think that soft skills is only dealt with the communication skills, that how you really communicate in English and how fluent you are in English. But it is not like that. In healthcare sector, if you will see, the soft skills majorly play a vital role, like empathy. That is very important while dealing with the patients, with their sensitivities, with their diseases. The communication skills, that how you are actually communicating with your patients, relatives, and your colleagues, your subordinates, doctors, nurses. Your time management skills, because life and death can be of 1 second. So your time management skills again play a very pivotal role. Your analytical thinking skills, the decision making skills, that how you have to deal with the difficult situations and how you have to deal in the emergency situations. And very important is the patience. The patience to deal and to listen to the patients and their relatives and to answer their queries very patiently and calmly.